After massive outrage over brutal gang rape and murder of a 50-year-old in Uttar Pradesh's Badayu, now Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh Yogi Adityanath has ordered the special task force to arrest the main accused and the temple priest who is currently absconding. So far, two accused have been arrested and a team has been constituted to probe the incident which took place, ladies and gentlemen, on Sunday, January 3rd. Chief Minister in action right now, but the problem is that the cases are not stopping in Uttar Pradesh, and that too absolutely soul-shattering, brutal cases. Shivendra Srivastav, my colleague, is joining us from Badayu right now. Shivendra, the Chief Minister giving the case to the SIT, but the fact is, Shivendra, whether the intentions of the state are honest or not, there seems to be absolute lawlessness when it comes to crime against women in the state of Uttar Pradesh.
See, Ankit, this is clear case of lawlessness in Uttar Pradesh. One side, CM Yogi Adityanath is giving strict directions. They are saying, UP government is saying that they are very rigid and very strict on like law and order situation in the state, and they are very sensitive about crime against women. Few months back, Hathras case was happened, and leniency from the police and administration was clearly shown. And now again, this is in Badayu. This incident was like reported on Sunday night, and they were running from pillar to post to senior officials to local police officers for registering this affair and to getting help from the medical staff as well. But nothing was done. And very shockingly, this is very shocking that on third day, on Tuesday, case was registered and then postmortem was done. And this is very, very serious thing that one side government is showing that they are very sensitive about these kind of incidents, and police officials, senior police officials, are acting very lenient. And this shows this case is very, 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 very normal case for UP police. And now, after this was reported in media and everyone is criticizing UP government, now they have registered FIR, they have formed SIT and okay. STF to assist local police, and also they have suspended. Yes. SO and other things are also being done. But one thing is very clear, Ankit, that UP police is not going to change at any cost. Whether CM is saying, whether like opposition is targeting, whatever is happening, but they are same since very beginning. Yeah.
You are right. And Shivendra, this is exactly why questions also need to be asked of the administration. Why is it that the Uttar Pradesh police is not changing? Is Yogi Adityanath, who comes out and portrays such a tough image of himself, he wants to encounter every other criminal. Is it too much to ask in the most populous state of the country from the Chief Minister, the Home Minister, the DGP, the other senior officials, that the clear message trickles down to the ranks? And the problem is, and Shivendra, I would request you to stay on with me, the problem is what we saw in Hathras, the blatant use of the police machinery, the blatant use of the administration to try and suppress, that very dark night where the victim was cremated without the wish of our parents. This emboldens the police not to act. And we are seeing after one case after another, be it Hathras, Muradnagar, any case that you take, and now the Badayu one, the initial reaction of the police is to try and somehow push everything under the carpet. It is a very, very brutal rape case, ladies and gentlemen. I was going through the postmortem report, and trust me, I covered 2012 Nirbhaya gang rape case. It's soul-shattering, what you read. The kind of last few hours of that woman on planet Earth were very, very horrific. I just want to give you a sense of what happened, the entire timeline of this entire case, so that you understand better of this entire laxity that we are talking about. Now, listen in. January 3rd, 6 p.m., the victim left her house for temple, and she used to go to this temple regularly almost every single day. Then on January 3rd itself, between 6 to 8 p.m., the victim is gang raped and brutalized. 8 p.m., the kin, after 2 hours, the victim is not found anywhere, she doesn't return home, they go to the cops, the nearest police station. The police were lax, they say, come back in the morning. Then January 3rd, 11 p.m., the accused left the victim outside her home. In fact, trying to put up a picture that she fell into a well and died. Then on January 3rd, 11:30 p.m., PCR call was made. The police refused to visit the victim's home. The SHO, the local police, the PCR, all those drama about dial 100 and everything, nothing came to aid of the family and the victim. Then January 4th, the body is taken by the police. And after 17 hours of protest by the family and the villagers, on January 5th, finally the police, after more than 2 days, sends the body for post-mortem. The post-mortem report is post-mortem is conducted, and the report reveals rape. It confirms rape. And then January 5th, the police lodges the FIR. Although two of the accused out of three have been arrested,